flame. Hold on, I can make it rain. Oh, Cody, hear the thunder. No, don't let it bring you down. Look up and see the light. You're not alone, don't give up like that. Oh, we yeah, got a ways to go. Break that wall, let the spirit flow.
I know you ain't there yet. Don't stop to catch your breath. You're going higher and higher, higher and higher. Let go, set me free. Got the streets all I need. You're going higher.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Fasten your seatbelts for one of the great divisional rivalries in the NFL. This is the first of two games between these teams this year, and you know it's going to be entertaining. It's the Titans going up against the Jaguars. For the call, let's send you out to the broadcast booth, where we'll join our commentators, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Larry, we welcome our viewers to Duval County, the northern part of Florida, and the largest city in the Sunshine State, as EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to Everbank Field here in Jacksonville. A few minutes prior to us coming on air, this crowd was jolted into action with the introduction of these Jaguars. They're set for football as the Jags are ready to match up with the Tennessee Titans. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you look at this Jaguar team. They come in off a good win on the road, and now they hit the home opener at 1-0. Meanwhile, for the visiting Titans, they too were winners last time out, so something's got to give here.
And I love it when both teams come in off of wins. Great mindsets, and it usually leads to a really well-played game.
Now here's the first carry for DeMarco Murray. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First down, Titans, gain of 12.
No other way to say it, but it was an off year for DeMarco Murray in Philadelphia, and Chip Kelly's offense didn't really seem to be a fit. But when he went to Tennessee playing for Mike Mularkey, boy, did he fit in a big way.
Finished third in the NFL in rushing behind Ezekiel Elliott and a late-charging Jordan Howard. He was ahead of Howard much of the year.
I remember Coach Mularkey in preseason said, DeMarco Murray's my... number one back, he'll get plenty of carries here, and he did.
Now some movement before the snap, and we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon.
Offense.
Yeah, that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. So after the mistake by the offense, it cost him 5 yards, and now first and 15. Throwing is Mariota. That one finds the rookie tight end, Jonnu Smith. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. They get the penalty yardage back, plus five more as they get it to second and five.
I don't mean to jump in on you, partner, but they didn't waste any time getting downfield, did they? I mean, a nice big play there.
Three plays, three successful plays in plus territory. Now this defense on its heels a bit.
It seems like they had something targeted there, doesn't it? It's like, okay, we've got a matchup we like coming right out of the gate. Let's go ahead and get right to it.
Completed pass on second down. Now it's third down as the defense looks for the stop. Unit out there. This is Fowler, the fullback. And the penetration too strong. He won't make it back to the line of scrimmage.
I get the thought process. Third and short, give it to the fullback, let him bulldoze his way, but that means you're counting on your offensive line to win the line of scrimmage, aren't you?
Yeah, and there was just a mass of bodies there at the line. Looked like more defenders than offensive guys. Winds up losing yardage. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. First rider from LSU, it's Leonard Fournette. And he's going to be taken down right at about the 15-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. On play action, now Bortles. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson. And he's brought down after a good game. A very solid gain of 27. If this Tennessee team is going to be one to watch, if they're going to be a factor in 2017, that pass defense has to improve. They were number 30 last year.
As a team, they should be more comfortable with the schemes that they're playing, as well as being able to add a few new ones because they've stayed stable on the defensive side and their staff. So what they're teaching now, they've learned before. They should be able to tune that up a little bit and get better play on the back end in order to improve that number from
2016. From the gun, it's Bortles. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. To throw, it's Bortles. He'll set up the screen to Fournette. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They get seven there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
When you surrender 24 turnovers in a season, what, 16 interceptions, 8 fumbles lost, Blake Bortles, you do hire a quarterback guru to try and get you right, don't you?
And that's what he did. Has to limit those turnover numbers, doesn't it?
He has a defense that's ready to play right now. He needs to help them by taking care of the ball.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. They came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. Murray now as they run it to start the drive. And he'll power his way up near the 25. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. So second and medium, second and 5 now. Again, it's Murray. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
On first down, Murray. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. And, Charles, we get a look here at the key inactives, and I tell you what, a big list for being this early in the season.
If there's any silver lining at all, you're hoping you can get these guys back, and now you'll play well down the stretch with them. But what you're also hoping is that the guys who have to play for them, the next man up mentality kicks in, and those guys take care of business.
That's a first down pickup for Tennessee on a gain of 10. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only the control and things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon.
Not an ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
Offense.
And that'll set them back five. Second down to the offense needing 5 yards. Following the penalty, it's Murray. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a third and one.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to him back.
They'll run here. It's Murray. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
I like his focus there because he wasn't thinking about breaking that one big. All he thought about was, I need one. Let's go get that. Ended up picking up two.
And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Encroachment, defense.
They'll step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know. Defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible. A little too quick on that one.
They'll run the counter with Murray. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
This has been a good drive so far, and it's been a running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
On the read option, it's Mariota. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. Tenth carry of the game now, Murray. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Derrick Henry, and he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. Derrick Henry, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Titans are able to strike for 6. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
A reminder, coming up tonight, Green Bay visits Atlanta. All sorts of storylines there. A playoff rematch, also the opening of Mercedes-Benz Stadium. And then on Monday night, the Giants host the Lions.
So the Giants play on Sunday night and Monday night to open the season.
Yeah, two under the lights. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call.
Offense.
So apparently some grabbing there in the middle of the O-line.
I've often wondered why that doesn't happen more often for guys that play center. Having to snap the ball and then trying to get your hands into the proper position, that's difficult to do. He got caught that time.
Bortles now to throw. Caught out left side by Robinson. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 18 yards to pick up there.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Second down, here's Bortles. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. Jarrell Casey. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now it's a quarterback third and long. You really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Thought they were going to force a fourth down. Instead, P.I. gives them the first.
And that's frustrating because you think you've taken them really deep into the count, haven't you? Instead, you've got to start all over. That could really, really be demoralizing.
Now Leonard Fournette. Fournette fighting through. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
I love it. A scout told me that with his running style, this guy's always the hammer, never the nail. But also,
I was on the field for a game he had last year at LSU, and there were some college boys warming up, and then Leonard Fournette walked in. He is a man.
Full grown.
Throwing on first down is Bortles. Finding room to the 20. Over the middle, the connection to Hearns. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Here we go, nice, nice.
And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football. But you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
To throw is Bortles. They set up the screen to Ivory. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Chris Ivory, his... touchdown here of the new campaign, and the Jaguars are within an extra point of tying this one up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. A drive that time of 6 plays, and it results in a touchdown for Jacksonville. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. Here's Eric Weems now on the return. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. They're in the second quarter at Heinz Field. Early on, it's the Vikings in the driver's seat. Sam Bradford leading the charge offensively. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. They go with Murray again, and able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Mariota now on second down. And this one caught by Delanie Walker. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A Titan first down, Mariota to Walker.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside, but they can really shred your defense.
Mariota to Decker over the middle. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. To throw Mariota, and complete to the tight end Walker, right side. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. This drive, it's been a good mix. Three passing plays, three runs, hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
False start, offense.
So that'll back him up five. Second down, Mariota. And Walker has it. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. Mariota again. Oh, he stays up. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, it's been a tough go for him. These guys have been driving down the field. But defensively, once they got their backs to the goal line, turned up the pressure, that's going to lead to a fourth down. Well played.
And Succop will put this one right through, and they take the lead here now at 10-7. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here.
And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And this one will go to the 28-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down. On second down, here's Fournette. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. If they want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
And unable to connect. If he had caught it, it would have been a first down. Instead, it's fourth. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught, they got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
8 yards on the pickup, and that'll be good for a Jacksonville first down. Here's Bortles to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. So this brings up a second and two. The play fake to Ivory. Now Bortles steps away to his left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Robinson. And he eventually goes down, but not before reaching the 30-yard line. Defense. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it is going to be 15 yards.
Only the Rams made fewer trips to the red zone than the Jags last year, but here they are in the red zone, first and 10. Now Bortles, and that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. He was looking to get it to Allen Hurns that time, and now it's second down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
And an update from the Circle City up in Indianapolis. And the Colts have opened it up a bit, leading by 2 scores. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. As we look at the numbers, the only thing that really matters is that we've got a tie game. We'll have another half here to figure out who can come out on top. All right, let's get straight to it. Here's some highlights from the first half. Titans have it early in the second. Henry's going to head outside to the right.
Now you folks don't know what you're missing. Missing Larry Ridley. Ready to get back, though, to this week 2 matchup. Let's get to it. It's a short kick, taking it to 15. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter 3.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. They'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave them with 2nd and 1 yard.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Now whistles here, and I believe one of the Jaguar linemen might have moved.
Foster offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. Throw on second down. And his throw here is incomplete. Allen Robinson, the intended receiver. And it's third down. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Throwing his Bortles on third down. And he's got it to Hearns. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. A big one there for the Jags. 18 yards, first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can right foot in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And that'll be incomplete. Marquise Lee, the intended target, and it's second down.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Now whistles here. And I believe one of the Jaguar linemen might have moved.
False start, offense.
So that one will be accepted. The handoff. Now Bortles. And he's got his man in stride. Complete. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A nice gain of 21 yards. And there they went, crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone. Sometimes you're throwing it between the zones. Sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
Again, it's Fournette. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
And Leonard Fournette impressing there with that run. It's hard to believe that no Jacksonville Jaguar has broken 1,000 yards since Maurice Jones-Drew in 2011. And Leonard Fournette could be that guy.
Even with the ankle injury last year at LSU, still averaged 6.5 yards per carry.
And absolutely intimidated opposing defenses. A lot of guys simply didn't want to tackle him.
It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a second and 11.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
Now Fournette. Fournette, first down, still going. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great effort there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Jaguars have moved out in front. Fournette had 22 rushing touchdowns as a sophomore in 2015 for LSU, only 8 in an injury-filled 2016, but now he's got his first NFL touchdown.
And you know he'd like to return to that college form that he exhibited when he put it in the end zone 20-plus times. And he has the build of a big back, but don't be surprised if he has a few touchdowns at a long distance. He has excellent speed as well.
The extra point now coming from Myers. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17 to 10. That time, a nine-play drive. And it was finished by the touchdown run from the 15. Here's Myers now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But a guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Mariota. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. Fighting down past the 45. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Tennessee getting the first down on a big play of 18 yards.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes that's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he's going to get this one down to the 45. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. And Matthews over the middle with a grab. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. A Tennessee first down. That one Mariota to Matthews.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Fresh set of downs here. They go play action here on first down. And some room to maneuver. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. A gain of 32 that time. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. They come up in an offset eye. They'll try to run for it with Henry. And he goes backwards on this one. Losing yardage to the 7. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Well, that run wasn't very successful. They did have a big one on the previous play. So you get the sense that the offense is probing around, trying to find the ones that are going to work. And when they find them, they'll keep coming back to them.
Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Delanie Walker, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And a great example there of just getting the feet in a tough spot. It seems like every year these guys get better at this.
Well, I think the drills get better that they work on, training camp, off-season work, OTAs. But also a lot of these guys have dance backgrounds, ballet backgrounds, and they take that and carry it over to the football field.
Suckup for the extra point. And he gets it to go, and we're all even, 17 apiece. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. To return it is Corey Grant. And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. And an update from the Circle City up in Indianapolis. And the Colts have opened it up a bit, leading by two scores. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. On first and 10, here's Bortles. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. He'll be dropped shy of the 40 despite powering through the tackle. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third.
They completed the screen, but one of the things you worry about is can the quarterback get rid of the ball before he's actually tackled? So your offensive linemen have to hold up the rushers a little bit because you want to make sure you keep your guy's jersey clean throughout the game.
The Jaguars on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9.
Here we go now.
They go play action for Yeldon. Now it's Bortles. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. And he gets this away, angled for the sideline with a lot behind it. Wow. Out of bounds and close. The question, was it a touchback? No. They'll say it crossed out at the 2-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Now they were good last time out with a touchdown drive. This go around, it's not going to be very easy starting from inside their own 5. And he's not going to get out of the end zone. Murray is taken down for the safety. Well, I think you can go ahead and give your punter an assist on that one. Pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by a great punt. And if the ball goes in the end zone, this never happens. So great call. Give the punt team and the punter some love.
And some space here. Whoosh. And an update from the Circle City up in Indianapolis. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. Out comes the Jaguar offense now as they get set to take over. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might...
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And a terrific return as he brings this one all the way back to the 30.
Blake Bortles simply cannot keep putting his team, putting his defense in these types of predicaments. He's got to take care of the football.
And last season, a lot of the turnovers just like this one in Jags territory. 11 of the 16 really put them in a tough spot in plus territory for the opposition. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's really difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
That was 2nd down run for Murray. And this may be a carbon copy as he'll again be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10.
But it was stopped on that play. He's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
The Titans on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Now Mariota going with a screen for Murray. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. Well, the screen gets seven, but it's not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
He dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
And Succop will put this one right through. And with that, they have taken the lead by a point here in the fourth. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know that field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Now a play fake here on first down. Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. Oh, free safety blitz. That can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he'd better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
On third and long, it's Bortles. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. Nortman on to kick as he sends it away. We'll call it a 42-yard punt, three on the return. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
The second down throw here for Mariota. And Walker with it over the middle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. It used to be occasional, right? Safety valve, throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
That one goes for 24 yards.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got to lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. First down, Titans, gain of 12.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal. How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what we said in the defensive huddle. Guys, you got to get no less than a 3.
And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Derrick Henry with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those 2 TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have 2 touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Getting set to go again, Blake Bortles marches back onto the field with his offense. And right now, probably just one thing in his mind, it's getting back to the hot start because he's really faded.
And ordinarily when that happens, the quarterback, as you know, is usually the leader of the squad. Now there's probably a silent camaraderie that comes about him saying, hey, guess what? We got you. Don't worry about it. Let's go, big fella.
And the Titan defense steps up here and down he goes. Derrick Morgan. Able to get in and run him down for a loss of 14. Now Bortles throwing on second down. Flushed out right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. Wait a second, they did not accept that after the incompletion. What? Your look is just as puzzled as mine.
I got nothing for you here. You have to take that penalty, don't you?
It's 3 yards. A 20th carry coming up now for Murray. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. I think this defense, tired of seeing him run the football, this D-line, probably getting sick of the O-line as well.
And as I'm watching this, I'm thinking about a conversation I had with Adam Gase, the head coach of the Miami Dolphins in the offseason. He told me that he asked his running backs each week for their favorite runs. Give me your 3 top runs. And right now, you're seeing a guy that's probably using his top runs to great advantage in this game.
He is in a zone. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a 2nd down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Mariota now. This is caught and snapped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Throwing here, Mariota. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now a 2nd timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave him with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. 2nd and goal from the 7. Murray. Showed some tough running, but they'll drop him at the 5-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their 3rd and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Murray, the lone setback. And they'll give it to him here. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. This defense bending but not breaking. It's a gain of three. It's now fourth and goal.
Let's just give credit where it belongs. The defensive front has out-leveraged the offensive guys trying to block them. We often say low man wins in tough situations. That's exactly what's happened here. Three straight runs, and they haven't been able to get into the end zone.
So barring something extraordinary, something crazy here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Brandon, this will be a great win for them. The better team's going to win this game, no question about it.
Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Now Bortles. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
Here we go now.
Back to the air on second down. It's Bortles being chased out left. And the catch made here by Marquise Lee. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. Give him 30 yards there. Throwing on first down is Bortles. He'll set up the screen to Fournette. Oh, Fournette loses it. It's out. It's picked up by the Titans. And he'll bring it all the way back, just a yard or two shy of midfield. Last week, now a fumble lost this week. Is this just growing pains of a rookie?
It is growing pains, but they can't afford them. Not him nor his team. That means extra work during the week with his coaching staff and extra work on his head to make sure he doesn't lose his confidence. They like him. They want him to flourish.
Because you know he wants to avoid that label of being a fumble machine.
It is a label that is hard to shed, and that just means teams come after you even more, ripping and raking at the football when you're carrying it.
And this looks to probably be the final play. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So for the Titans, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they will head home next week to take on the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for Jacksonville, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll be at home for one next week as the Baltimore Ravens come to town. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we sign off from Jacksonville.
You know, I'm like, yeah, nice P, you know?
What up, P?
Man.
When I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me. I bring them things, I bring them.